Hi, in this video we discuss Zepto CAPSULORHEXIS in difficult cataract cases with implantation of premium IOLs. Now we all know that CAPSULORHEXIS is crucial, and an ideal CAPSULORHEXIS should be well sized, well centered with 360 degrees overlap of the rhexis margin over the IOL optic to achieve a correct effective lens position. This effective lens position is crucial in premium IOLs as it affects the performance of these IOLs. The common techniques achieving a capsulotomy are cystotome, CAPSULORHEXIS forceps, micro-incision CCC forceps, etc. And they can be used in most cases, but it is quite difficult to achieve a rhexis in mature cataracts, white cataracts with anterior capsular fibrosis. Now this is a white cataract where the anterior capsule has been stained using tri-pan blue, and then a cystotome is used to perform a CAPSULORHEXIS. But as you can see, it is difficult to have a controlled size CAPSULORHEXIS. The rhexis ends up being very small. We cannot achieve a uniform standard size or repeatable rhexis in these cases. This is another white cataract where the rhexis is being performed with a capsulotomy, and here we see the Argentinian flag sign, which we are all scared of. Here we are using Utrata CAPSULORHEXIS forceps. This provides a slightly greater control, but again, these kind of forceps depend a lot on the skill of the surgeon and are not uniformly reproducible, and the size and position is not perfectly controlled. Sometimes these rhexis are not perfectly well centered either. So in difficult cases, we can perform a CAPSULORHEXIS using either a femto laser, a Zepto nanopulse technology, and new techniques called a capsule laser and aperture CTC. The femto laser is used quite commonly. The difficulty with the femto laser rhexis is that it is expensive, the rhexis has tags, you need a separate room, and you also need extra time. This is a femto capsulotomy being performed with the femto laser machine, and despite all its limitations, the femto laser achieves a perfectly round CAPSULORHEXIS. Now, the capsule laser is not yet commercially available. It has also not got FDA approval. The capsule laser fires a laser in single circular pattern, and it fires continuously. This is the rhexis that has been achieved with the capsule laser, and it is quite strong, as you can see here. This is the console that comes with the capsule laser. This laser can be attached to the operating microscope itself, and therefore you do not need another separate big machine or a room, and it makes it quite portable. The other device in pipeline is the aperture CTC. It has tips of various sizes. This is the tip, and this is the centering point for centering the diameter of the capsulotomy. The advantage with all these new devices is that the capsulotomy can be well positioned under direct visualization through the microscope, so it can be very well centered. The aperture CTC, or the continuous thermal capsulotomy, works through a steel ring, and it is a non-laser based system. Continuous controlled low level energy is provided to the cutting elements on the steel ring, and this creates a smooth, repeatable, uniform capsulotomy or CAPSULORHEXIS in difficult cases of cataract also. Our focus in this video is on the Zepto nanopulse technique. This device is commercially available, it is handy, and it has also gained the FDA approval in June 2017. This is a case of Zepto cataract surgery in a 5-month-old child, and to the best of our knowledge, this is the first instance of a Zepto rhexis in such a small child. The child presented with bilateral significant congenital cataract, and as we all know that achieving a good rhexis is quite difficult in the thin elastic capsules of children. The capsule has been stained. This is the Zepto console. This is the handpiece, which is based on a vitrectomy handpiece. It is a disposable handpiece. This is the nitinol ring in the silicone suction cup. The nitinol is a shape memory alloy, so it always comes back to its original position. It can be placed in the anterior chamber in a retracted position, and once inside the anterior chamber, the suction cup and the nitinol ring is opened. Once we are satisfied with the position and the centering of the ring, we apply suction through the console of the Zepto machine. And after the suction is applied, nanopulse technology is delivered, which causes vaporization of the water molecules trapped between the capsule and the nitinol ring, and this causes a perfectly centered smooth rhexis in one go. Unlike the femto, the laser pulses are not applied sequentially, and the 360 degree rhexis is achieved in one shot. After removing the cataract, we have performed a posterior capsulectomy and an anterior vitrectomy, and intracameral triamcinolone has been injected to check for any vitreous in the anterior chamber and also to provide some post-operative anti-inflammatory effect. This is the second patient where Zepto cataract surgery was done with implantation of a trifocal IOL in a case of an intumescent cataract. As we can see, this is a white cataract. We make the side port incision and stain the anterior capsule. The Zepto handpiece can be inserted through a 2.2 mm incision or through whatever main incision we have made for the cataract surgery. This again is the silicone suction cup with the nitinol or the nickel titanium ring. The ring is well positioned and centered through direct visualization under the microscope, and then we apply the vacuum and the nanopulse technology and we have a smooth rexis in one go. As you can see, the margins of this rexis are extremely smooth. Now here we can actually see the beauty of the rexis, which is circular and uniform and will also achieve 360 degrees overlap on the IOL optic, which is important for achieving the right effective lens position. This is the Tri-Def trifocal IOL marketed by the Care Group India, which is being implanted into the capsular bag. And here you can see the well-centered IOL with a good coverage of the rexis margin on the IOL optic. This is the third case, which is a hypermature Morganian cataract with 2 diopters of astigmatism, and we are planning to implant a toric multifocal IOL after the marking and the staining. We prepare the handpiece of the Zepto device and inject the device into the anterior chamber. With direct visualization under the microscope, we center the capsulotomy device and then apply the nanopulse technology. And as you can see here, there is a lot of milky fluid coming out as expected in this Morganian cataract, and we can understand that a manual capsulorhexis would have been extremely difficult in this case. But because a 360 degree simultaneous capsulotomy is created, the fluid escapes altogether and there is no risk of an Argentinian flag sign. So to summarize, the Zepto technique or the precision pulse capsulotomy is a new and accurate device for achieving uniform, repeatable, well-centered capsulorhexis in all difficult cases like white cataracts, hypermature Morganian cataracts, cases with anterior capsular fibrosis, etc., where the rexis is extremely difficult. This merges seamlessly with the cataract patient workflow and does not require additional rooms or additional space, and it also allows direct visualization under microscope. The potential limitations are that it may be difficult to insert this device in cases with shallow anterior chamber. However, in preclinical studies, it has been noted that there is no significant endothelial cell loss as compared to manual rexis in the contralateral eyes in rabbit studies or preclinical studies. So we can use this technology to achieve a good capsulorhexis in difficult cases and expand the use of premium IOLs in these cases. Thank you.